Mommy, why was that man's underwear so small?
Yeah, so growing up, Beth Page, Long Island, there was a... our neighborhood was called the numbered streets. It was 1 through 13. It was just a basic grid.
Yeah, yeah.
And my grandfather lived on 5th Street.
Kind of like the miles in Detroit.
Yeah.
5 miles, 6 miles, 7 miles,
so,
8 miles.
So my grandfather lived on 5th Street. My Uncle Nick lived right next door. The Cafiros lived right across the street. Then you had Millie across the street. It was an incredible block. It was like out of a movie. And then these block parties became the thing of legend. They were incredible. I mean, we had a parade. All the parents were drunk. There was bobbing for apples, the egg toss, the pinata,
kids
the
just
DJ.
Getting stuck in the head with lawn darts.
Yeah, what else?
Petting zoo?
Yeah, no curfew in the parade. That's where the famous, there's, my grandfather used to sit on the back of a convertible.
Hell yeah.
And they made him a shirt that said Mayor of Bethpage.
That rules.
He wasn't really the mayor, but he was the unofficial mayor of Bethpage because everyone knew my grandfather. So he would be the guy, you know, the grand... the parade.
Yeah, he'd be the Ringling
Grand
Brothers.
Marshall.
P.T. Barnum. I loved a good block party.
So the block parties were legendary. So, yeah, we got together to say goodbye to my grandfather earlier this week. He passed away, 98 years old. I love you. I miss you. And the stories start flowing. And then my cousin Adam says to me, he goes, hey, do you remember there being a stripper at the block party one year? And I went, what are you talking about?
Huh?
I go, I don't remember it. He goes, dude, he goes, I had this memory. And he goes, and I don't know where it came from. He goes, I don't think I made it up. He goes, why would my brain make up the fact that there was a stripper at our block party? Because he had the same thing. He had a very fuzzy recollection of it. And then he goes, last year, I'm at my mom's house, my Aunt Angie, and he goes, we're going through old photos. And he goes, what do I stumble upon? He goes, photos of the stripper at the block party, confirming my fuzzy memory that there was a stripper. And I go, dude, I don't know what you're talking about.
What are you talking about? There's no way you could have been there.
He goes, I don't think I was there. Yeah. I don't remember.
Must have skipped that year.
And sure enough, he goes into his phone. And brings up these photos, and there was an effing stripper on my grandfather's front lawn.
A male stripper.
A male stripper with fire. One of the pictures that he has fire. He's in a pink thong.
Uh-huh.
He's doing the moves. And then, like, there's a couple of photos facing the stripper. Then there's a couple of photos from behind the stripper.
And who's in the front
and
row?
And you see the crowd. First of all, the crowd is gigantic.
It looks like the lawn at Meriwether. It's massive.
There are so many people in that photo. And then if you zoom in, the lower left, who's in the front
row?
Who's
in the photo?
With a He-Man sweatshirt on with my name on it. It says Scott. I'm in the front row.
You're watching a dude with his tackles flopping around.
I must have blocked this out because I still really don't have any memory of it. In one picture, you see my grandfather in the background with his arms crossed. Just not having
it. This.
Is it mostly children that were there?
There was a little group of kids in the front, but the rest were just all adults.
One kid is too many. And there
yes,
were a lot.
There are way more kids
there's
than
old
there
women.
Should have been.
There seems to be people that were involved in the local church. People,
here's
all of the demographics
thing.
That would be not into a stripper were there.
The block party is where do you hang out? You hang out on the block, in the streets. In the front yard,
okay.
Everyone's there. If they wanted to do something like this, go into one of the backyards
yes.
And be like, hey, no kids allowed back here for
yeah.
the next 15 minutes.
This is the
minutes.
VIP area.
Yes, make
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah.
It was on the front lawn of my grandfather's house, a male stripper. It was insanity.
I'm dying to know who he was, who hired him, who thought it was a good
idea.
Here's
what we have figured out. So these photos surfaced. There was the two of him in the pink thong. That was my cousin Adam, the guy that lives in L.A. He's
okay.
A screenwriter and music producer and all that. He had those. Then my cousin Steven, his brother, had a bunch of other photos. So we've collected all the photos now. And apparently it was my Aunt Joni who was a bit of a wild card to begin with. She's since been divorced from my Uncle Nick. But, yeah, she was a wild child. It was her mom's birthday. So I guess she hired a stripper for her mom's, I guess, hired entertainment. I don't know what she thought she was hiring or if this is exactly
it
what
wasn't
she
a singing
wanted
telegram.
To hire. But apparently this guy was hired for an elderly woman's birthday. And I guess it was meant to be funny or I don't
that.
Know what it was meant to be. But The photos are just shocking.
If I had told you, if I'd have told you this story, and no one would have believed me, nor should you have.
Well, that's what my cousin was saying.
And then you see the pictures.
He goes, I don't. He goes, how could this memory of mine be right? He goes, it's fuzzy, but I'm pretty sure there was a stripper at our block party. He goes, why would my brain make that up? He goes, it doesn't make any sense. And then he found the pictures, and his head split in half. He's like, here is the smoking gun. Here is the evidence. Here is the holy grail. I have found the photos.
Do you know who he looks like? And I hope you're following along on the home version. Scott underscore Reardon underscore radio. And I think even the JSS, if not 98 Rock accounts, put it up. But if you can't, and you were a movie fan, do you remember Goodfellas, the gangster that got and was found frozen in the back of the meat truck, Frankie Carboni?
No.
If you hold on, I love him when my monitor turns off. This guy's got such a distinct look. I mean,
no, that's Long Island, dude. He's Italian too. He's from Long Island.
He's that gangster from Goodfellas.
Oh yeah.
That's him.
Yeah,
he's Carboni from Goodfellas. And this guy,
dude, the boombox, the pink thong,
the flame,
the bow tie, the fire.
The last thing a kid sees before he's burned to death is a dude's balls.
What somebody called the scorpion move, where he puts his legs up over there. You could just see it.
Dude, the worm.
I am like 3 feet from this dude's giant hog just flopping in my face.
And your face is frozen. I'm not saying you were cheering at any point or asked for an autograph. The face you made in that photo,
oh my God,
I assume was on your face the entire time. The women in the lawn chairs sitting to your left and the right of the photo. Man.
I can see my Uncle Nick in there. There's me. There's my cousin Joseph. There's my cousin Chris. The neighbor, I see Janine Pachenko, my cousin Steven. Like, we're all just there. Front and center, ready for entertainment. And then this dude just gets naked.
He is completely nude. Also, I've done some bad shows in my time where I have been, you know, hired to perform at someone's house and I'm on a deck with a karaoke machine.
Yeah.
And it's not well. This guy is dancing near what I think is a lemon tree. Near balloons,
yep.
There's some people in the background sitting on stoop.
Yeah, how did he go ahead with the performance?
How did he still do it?
How did he not just look around and go, I'm sorry, I can't do this.
I can't
strip for an entire block party. And there's, 60 kids sitting
there. There's children everywhere. Also, this is an Italian neighborhood.
This
is an Italian neighborhood. And to say, and I don't think I'm speaking out of turn here, that there's some strong feelings that an Italian husband might have towards his wife and her eyes wandering towards another man's crotch. Did anyone want to kick this guy's ass?
I barely have a memory of it.
Beat him behind a garage?
Go to the one where he's in the scorpion pose, and right behind his feet, against the house, who do you see there with arms crossed?
That's Pops.
That's Pops.
That's Pops.
My grandfather's in the background.
With the Polly Walnut haircut, too.
Yes, with his arms crossed. I'm nothing.
Who's the dude with the beer rested on his gut?
I don't know who that guy is.
That guy ain't into it also.
Oh, my God.
I know. Go and look at the photo online. Scott underscore Reardon underscore radio. So you've got you in the front row. Mm. Then in the third photo where your grandfather can be seen, there's another row of all the kids up front. Not the young ladies, not the horny housewives, not the widower, not the grandmother, who would be funny to get a lap dance. They sent the children up.
If I had to guess, I would probably say I'm maybe 6 or 7 years old. So this was probably 82, 83
You're
or something
adorable,
like that.
By the way.
You are a cute kid. How you weren't kidnapped is beyond me.
And I'm not, I don't easily give out compliments.
I don't know what happened, but I used to be adorable.
You should have been snatched up and sold on the international market.
This was a great little find for my grandfather's funeral.
I just keep finding Easter eggs in these photos.
Well, if you look, the one lady has I Heart Our Block Party shirt.
I saw that.
And then if you look down to the bottom left, there's another one down there. We had our own t-shirts
made. That little girl, she's got one on.
This block party was, as a kid, right, everything seems larger than life. But this was like, if you were to do a block party for a movie and everything looks amazing in movies. Yeah. It was that cool.
It was like Scorsese would have filmed this for the first 15 minutes of an Italian neighborhood.
100%.
The mustaches in some of these things.
Dude.
Oh my God. Rides are a nickel. That guy
That's
in the
my
background.
Uncle Nick. That's my Uncle Nick. That's Nunziante.
And the dude with the tie that looks like
I don't know who that is.
Avril Lavigne dressed him. God, that is amazing. We might need to reach out to Ma Dukes. We might even need to reach out to Ron. Ron, do you remember what they called him?
They used to call him the horse.
Yeah, I'd love to find out about their recollection of this because it's beautiful.